Hello. The last video I put up was of this three-phase blower running, and it kind of reminded me that I had another old motor sitting around for about a decade that I wanted to get running and that I didn't have a drive circuit for. So, I figured I might as well build one. And it's basically just a sensorless, brushless DC motor controller. There's some really tiny surface mount parts going on. Well, just one part really, but the soldering to that took a long time. That's all lead free. And I ordered some other parts, some 600 volt 10 amp MOSFETs, some MOSFET drivers, and also some little power supplies to run each one of the drivers, since the way they work is the bootstrap technique, which isn't exactly conducive to motor control. There's also a current sense resistor, a 5-volt regulator which runs everything, and that runs off its own separate wall board. So I got a small cooling fan there on low speed just to keep anything from overheating, because while I was messing around with this, I actually blistered the plating on one of the MOSFETs. It still works, but it'll never sit flat on a heatsink. So, if you ever work with something like this, always order spares. And also, while messing around, one of these little trim pots just had a stress fracture and broke the leg off. So, basically, I just got a big pot in the box that I put together the other day. And that's sort of a pulse width modulation speed control part of the IC to control the speed. Unfortunately, the back EMF feedback circuit is extremely sensitive to any kind of noise, so the motor will frequently halt and cause the driver transistors to overheat, so I just have everything running off of variac that's connected to the power transformer, diodes, capacitors, and that is basically variable anywhere between about 0 and 40 volts. I also have a lot of other fun things to try to get running on that. Old hard drives. I got 2.5, a couple of 3.5s, and even a 5.25 quantum Bigfoot whenever I actually put it back together, because I forgot I took it apart. So I have to put the platters back on. Most of the motors I have actually do have sensors in them, but I can't disassemble them enough non-destructively to actually see how to connect them. So, using a non-sensor type brushless DC controller actually makes that, well, a lot easier. It's just 3 wires to the motor faces, which you can easily identify with an AC voltmeter and just giving it a good spin around. The other problem with this controller is it's actually a clock device. So there's a ceramic resonator. I've got a 4 megahertz and an 8 megahertz. And that actually controls the startup speed and the maximum speed, which is kind of disappointing because the startup speed for a lot of them is too fast, and the maximum speed, I often hit that before I'm actually done turning up the voltage. So I may actually have to flip these switches to actually while it's running in order to work around that. But I'm not going to waste any more time, I'm just going to get this thing turning. Power on. And this is what I mean about the startup speed being a little bit off. You have like a major amount of rotational inertia, it doesn't want to go right away. So frequently I'll just have to actually just start it going by hand. Turn the voltage down a little bit until it catches. And I've also connected a multimeter up to function as a frequency counter so I can determine exactly how fast it's turning. I'm not sure if this is an 8-pole or a 4-pole, but it's I can tell pretty quickly here just by looking. Yeah, that has a frequency generation pulse of 154 Hz, and it's... I'm judging from that noise, it's probably about 1500 RPM, so it's basically something like 1/10. So operating frequency for this, not exactly sure what it is. Pull this back a little bit. I have a wide-angle adapter lens for this camera on order, so hopefully for future videos we can see a bit more of what's going on. It's about 3,000 RPM with a motor voltage of 11.8 on the DC bus. So I'm going to turn it up to about 24 volts. Okay, that's 24 volts, and the motor is spinning around at 6,000 RPM there, it's about 5,900. I'm going to turn it up to full power from the transformer. Actually, a fairly well-balanced unit. And based on frequency, it's zipping around at about 8200 RPM. This is running on. About 34 volts. So there, that's how you basically how you get a... Let's see, how good this be. Probably a 20 to 25 year old Seagate hard drive to do over 7200 RPM. And I can't really help it, but I gotta goof off. I'm gonna do that again real quick. And let's see exactly what RPM it actually achieves at 140 volts going into the transformer. I don't want to do it too long because it's a small transformer and I don't want it to overheat. And that's about 500 RPM shy of 10,000. I'm perfectly happy to do it. little red LEDs come through the frequency generator. Now just turn it off. Absolutely nothing going into it. And we'll just let it coast down. Bearings in this thing are ridiculous. Didn't even get warm. Oh, next video, I'm probably going to start messing around with some of the other ones. This little one here, I just bolted to a heat sink because there's really no other way to easily attach it to, you know, or just even let it sit on the table. So this is out of an old corner. Can't remember what the capacity was. I think it might have been something like 210 megabytes or something along those lines. It's all older stuff. Older 3.5 Seagate. This one, it's not balanced as well, but it goes a lot faster. So I might try that one next.